Hi everyone, welcome back to Earl Grey Books. I'm Ellie and today it is time for my mid-month wrap-up for April. So this one is a little bit late. I just had a lot of videos that I needed to get up, and since I had that little bit of a break at the start of the month, I was kind of running out of time and I didn't really have time to film this. So we're here today. It's going to be a pretty short one. I've only got 6 books to talk about. We're gonna jump straight in. First up, I read Just Us by Claudia Rankine. This is a essay collection. There's a little bit of poetry in there as well. I really, really enjoyed this. I love Citizen by Claudia Rankine, which is her poetry collection. And so as soon as I heard this one was coming out, I was super excited for it. It's really beautiful, but it is definitely one that gotta have a Percy interruption at some point. It's definitely one that I think I'm gonna have to reread a couple of times before I truly appreciate everything that's in here, because there's a lot. So it comes with essays, like I said, which are on the left hand side, and then on the right hand side there is additional material, sometimes like references to things, sometimes photographs, sometimes images, and all sorts of different things. So I feel like, yeah, it's one that I'm gonna have to read a couple of times before I to really get everything. And yes, next up I listened to an audiobook. It was just a poem, so don't be too proud of me. But I listened to The Hill We Climb by Amanda Gorman. This was part of the Libro FM ACL program for April. So I listened to that one. I really, really enjoyed it. I think that it's maybe not quite as meaningful to me, as I'm not American. So I think the poem as a whole is really great, but I think there are a couple of moments where if you're not American, it doesn't hit as hard as if you were, but it's still a really great poem. Next up, we had a DNF, and that was Matilda and Other Stories by Mary Shelley. You might know that Frankenstein is one of my favorite books of all time, and I'm kind of obsessed with Mary Shelley. But this was just complicated. So I read Matilda, the title story, and it's very weird and uncomfortable, but I liked it. For, I guess, the writing, not so much the story. It's about a father who is in love with his daughter, so it's a bit uncomfortable. And I read quite a few of the other stories in here. A lot of them take place in Italy, which is really interesting, but I kind of made it halfway through this and they were all starting to kind of feel the same. So decided to DNF it, but I am keeping this one. And I may decide to come back to it in the future and, continue to read it then. We'll see. Next up, we had some historical romance. We've got these two, which is Lord of Fire and Lord of Ice by Galen Foley. Books 2 and 3 in the Night Miscellany series. This is a really interesting series in that it doesn't really follow the usual mold of a historical romance. Every single book, I think I said this in my vlog when I was reading them, every single book has this kind of like, what the actual hell moment. They all have very interesting premises. This one, I think it's this one. kind of starts with a like hellfire sex cult thing. And yeah, it's just, there's a lot of like intrigue and mystery. And yeah, it's kind of some like, all right, that's the thing that happened kind of moments, if you know what I mean. So yeah, I really like this series. It's a lot of fun. You do kind of have to suspend your disbelief a little bit. It is fun. So I will be continuing this series hopefully in May. There are 7 books in the series, so I own all of them. Gotta get to reading them. And then finally, again, if you watch that vlog, you will have seen this, but I read House of Hollow by Crystal Sutherland. This one came out either earlier this month or in March, depending on where you are. I really like this. This is kind of like a gothic horror, creepy. It's YA. It follows 3 sisters, and they disappeared briefly as children and then came back with, they all had these scars on their throats and they can't remember what happened, and this is kind of them discovering it. I have a full review of this one, and yeah, I really, really liked it. It was, again, it was kind of fun to read. It reminds me a little bit of Mexican Gothic as well. So if you liked that, this might be worth picking up. And that's it. That's the wrap up for this half of the month. I want to keep this video kind of quick because I need to get back to doing things. So I will leave it here. I hope you're all doing super well, and I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.